Bagua originally comes from Taoistic circle walking meditation. And this is what we start now with, okay? With the walking Qigong of Bagua, without arms. And we will do a couple of rounds, yeah? We will go now together on a journey in a circle. We spend a bit time here. And the first round, I want you to focus just on one thing. Also, if you all know this already, like if some of you know all of the details already, still, forget everything, you just focus on this one thing. Because especially now the first one, also advanced people do it, like get sloppy in it again and again. Yeah? And this first detail is the inner foot, straight, the outer foot hooking 45 degree in. Inner foot completely straight, outer foot hooking in. Straight means now here, the line of my outer foot defines what is straight. So now straight means this. If my outer foot is like this, straight is this. Okay? Always the outer foot defines the straight line for my inner foot. What happens a lot is people start to do this. Yeah? Not straight hooking. Because they want to go around the circle, and then it of course helps to turn it in. Yeah? But this is the game here, this is the beauty of the step work, not to do this. We start standing on Earth, trigram. We'll talk another time a bit more about the trigrams, but Earth is in the north, and the north is here. Yeah? Facing with our left leg towards the center, walking here towards the right, my right side now. On every trigram, you do two steps, okay? My first step, my inner foot, is on the trigram, Earth. My outer foot is going to the next trigram, mountain, and the inner foot stays on mountain. The next step, water, water. Wind, wind. So like this, on every trigram, two steps, you have in the end 16 steps, okay? So this you take care. And inner straight, outer hooking, nothing else. Floor first. Yeah? It's not the heel, it's the ball of the foot. Ha. Touching first. Okay? Be there also super precise. The second thing we add now already is the feet exchange close to each other. Yeah, not like this. Yeah. But super close. Every time, ankle and knees can touch. Yeah, don't have to, but I actually think it's good to touch, then you feel it, it's close. Okay? So you have now three things to take care of. Inner straight, outer hooking, ball of the foot first, and exchanging tight, like it's like you walk through mud. Tang ni bu in Chinese. And this mud, Schlamm, Schlammschritt, dass man durch Schlamm geht. And this is now important, I say it now, because for the next detail, then it starts to make sense why it's the mud step. Yeah? We have all in all 8 basic details for the mud step, okay? We have now 3. Inner foot straight, outer foot hooking. Touching with the ball of the foot first, that's number 2. And exchanging close is number 3, okay? Number 4, and this here it becomes now interesting, is now the rear foot, how you lift it. Because most of you did know this. Yeah, you rolled the foot. But what we want to do here now is you keep the heel on the floor as long as you can, shift the weight forward, and then in the last moment you just boop, release it. Like you stucking in mud, and then you release it. Yeah? The thing is, I want to keep actually my foot all the time facing to the earth. Like I'm walking on a magnet. And this is also the skill you build up with the time, with this constant earth connection. Yeah? Letting the Yongchuan point always be in connection with earth. Yeah, the middle point of the foot. Boom. Yes. This will teach with the time a really good rooting in step work. While moving, now we have here the step work in a really unstable position. And in this we need now to learn, okay, how in this step work I can build up rooting. Yeah, in the beginning you shake, sometimes you lose the balance even, and then with the time it gradually becomes more and more difficult with add-ons, yeah, that we have there. And this is building up this earth connection in step work. Okay, so this is the detail number 4. Keeping the heel on the floor, shifting the weight, and then boop, releasing. So our step is just a releasing of pre-tension that we created again. The same what we did today, creating tension, releasing it, right? This is what we do with the step work, creating tension and releasing it, boom. Now the fifth detail that is important to create this tension is the lower belly, the tailbone. Yeah? If your tailbone is facing up and the lower back is curved, you can shift the weight and extend the knee, no problem. But this is not it. But if you pull the lower back down, the tailbone especially, and curve the lower back, you cannot extend the knee. Yeah? The tension of the muscles is preventing it. You will feel here in the whole chain like a tension. Stretching your muscles here. And this stretch you use, boop, and release. So all the time you try now, keeping the lower back round and the tailbone pulling towards earth. Like there's a wire that is constantly connecting your tailbone to the floor, downwards, yeah? Eight details to take care of in the same time. This brings a lot of awareness into your legs, into your feet. And with this awareness, we go into a kind of meditation and we widen our possibilities with the legs. Yeah. So now, it's actually what is coming now is we do until 7. The last detail I will bring in the coming days, because this is more difficult. So now, to this pulling down of the lower of the tailbone, we pull the baihui up. Okay, basic qigong. While we empty the chest. Okay, so the chest is empty, the crown of the head is pulling the head up. So with every step now, because we challenge this here with the heel on the floor, because when the heel is on the floor, naturally the tailbone wants to come up again, right? So now with every step challenging this, we stretch with the tailbone and the baihui, the spine more. Boom. So every step is a stretch. Stretch for the spine. Okay. The end of the spine getting even more pulled down, while the crown of the head is pulling up all the time. In the same time, this is now the 7th detail already, you inhale to the lower belly. So now I want you to do the step really slow. You shift forward, you inhale, and exhale, you step. This usually you don't do it this slow and wait here, but to practice this now, I want you to every step shift, control your position, pull down, pull up, inhale. And the inhale will help you even more to stretch the spine. And then exhale, you release. Creating tension, releasing tension. And with this, you will feel you pump from the floor, things up into the spine.